Okay, in this video I'm going to model for you the conversions between mixed numbers and improper fractions, and we'll also talk mathematically how to do that. But first let's begin with some models, and I'm going to use my pattern blocks. This is a hexagon, and I'll just introduce the pieces. This is a trapezoid, here's a rhombus, and this is a triangle. And so this rhombus represents one half of the hexagon. The blue rhombus represents one third. It would take three of them to create one of these hexagons. And then you're going to need six of those triangles to equal one whole unit or one hexagon. So that was just a little review. Let's go ahead and do some fractions, or I'm going to create some fractions using these. So here we have a yellow hexagon, which equals one, and this represents one half of the hexagon. So we could write the fraction as one half. Now, we could also represent it just using these trapezoids, okay? Instead of having one half, we could substitute this hexagon for two more halves. See what I did there? So this represents a whole now. And so instead of having one whole and a half, we also have three halves. Okay? And so this is in mixed number form. This is in improper fraction form. So let's go ahead and do a couple of these. Here's my hexagon, and I'm going to say that we have one whole and two thirds. Okay, remember each of these represents a third. Now if I substitute this with thirds, let's see what we get. So now you can see we have a one whole and two thirds, but instead of using a one whole, we've got three, four, five, so five thirds. So one and two thirds is equivalent to five thirds. Okay? Let's go ahead and work with the triangles now. Let's say we have our one, and we're gonna let's use four of these triangles, and we'll see what we come up with here. So we've got our one and then four, and each of these represents one sixth, so we've got four sixths. Now if we were to just use triangles to represent all of this, remember we're going to need six of them. So I'll just quickly put them together to look like the hexagon so you can see it. So there's our one whole unit made up of six. So there's six sixths here plus four here. So six and four equals ten. Ten sixths. Okay. Let's do one more. Let's say we've got, instead of just one, let's say we've got two units, two whole pieces, and let's just say we've got one third. Okay, so we've got two and one third. Two and one third. Okay, and we're going to need some more one thirds, aren't we? So let's redo this using just thirds. So here's one, and we get a couple more. And then that was our, there's our second whole unit, and then our remaining piece. So we've got three thirds and another three thirds, so that's be six thirds plus one third is seven thirds. Okay, see how I just count up using my unit thirds. That's what this one represents. Okay, now Let's go ahead and talk about how we can get from a mixed number. How do we get from a mixed number to an improper fraction? And we're going to do that mathematically. So that means we're putting the model aside, we're just going to look at the numbers. Let's look at this first one here, 1.5. I'm going to rewrite it here. And I already know my answer is 3 seconds. But mathematically, what we're doing is we're taking the denominator, which is 2, and we're going to multiply it by the whole number, and then add the numerator. That's going to be our new numerator. The denominator remains the same. See what I did there? I'm multiplying the denominator to the whole number, and then I'm adding the numerator. Okay, let's go ahead and evaluate this. 2 times 1 is 2, plus 1 is going to be 3, and my denominator is 2. Okay, and notice, we got that. Let's try the next one. 1 2/3. I'll give myself a little more room here. So again, we're going to take the 3 and multiply it to the 1 and then add it to the 2. So I'm going to rewrite that. 3 times 1 plus 2 over 3. And when I evaluate that, I've got 3 times 1 is 3 plus 2 is 5 over 3, 5/3. And sure enough, that's what I've got. Okay, let's continue on. We've got the 1 4/6. Well, that's going to be 4 times 1 plus 4, or excuse me, 6 times 1 plus 4 over 6. 6 times 1 is 6 plus 4 is 10. 10/6. Nice. And the last one was 2 1/3, and that's going to be, you probably already have the answer, but I'm just writing it out. 3 times 2 plus 1 over 3. 3 times 2 is 6, plus 1 is 7, and 3 is my denominator. Okay, so this is the way that you're going to be converting a mixed number to an improper fraction. Let me go ahead and give you one that we did not do in the model and see if you can come up with a correct answer. And let's say we have 4 7/8. What is that going to be as an improper fraction? So you can pause the video here if you want to work on it. I'm going to go ahead and do the problem. 8 times 4 plus 7 over 8, that's 32, plus 7 is 39, 39/8. Okay. All right, now we're going to move on. We're going to actually go in the other direction. We're going to move from improper fraction to mixed number. So let's just do a couple of these that we already did. So if we had 3/2, okay, so let me write this out. Improper fraction to mixed number. Okay, improper fraction to mixed number. Now, when we see this, this is an improper fraction, but it's also a division problem. Okay, fractions are also, when they're written like this, it looks like a division problem. And so we're just going to divide, and I'm going to show you what that's going to look like. The numerator always goes under the division sign. The 2, the denominator, is always the divisor. And then we divide. 2 goes into 3 one whole time. And then we subtract, and our difference, this number here, is going to be transported over here. This will now be our numerator, and then the denominator here goes here. So again, we've got the one, it goes in this position, and then, let me get a different color, this divisor, or which is our original denominator, is now the denominator of our new fraction. That looks kind of messy there, but let's do a couple more. Let's say we have 5/3, and we know that's going to be 1 2/3, but let's just go ahead and check. 5 divided by 3, 3 goes into 5 once, find the difference, we get 2 left over, that 2 gets transported up here, and the 3 is our denominator, so 1 2/3. And we'll do a couple more. Let's do one more on the list, the 10/6. And again, that's going to be 10 divided by 6. 6 goes into 10 once. Find the difference. We get 4 left over, 4/6. Okay. Now, later we'll talk about reducing, but for this type of problem, that's okay. Let's do that last one that I had you do. We came up with 39/8, and we want to make sure we come up with 4 7/8 because that's what we started with. So let's go ahead and divide 39 by 8. 8 goes into 39 4 times. 4 times 8 is 32. Subtract, I get 7. 7 is my numerator, 8 is my denominator. And if we go back to the original problem when I was talking about that, that's what we started out with, 4 7/8. And so that's a nice thing. When you do have a mixed number, you could easily figure out the improper fraction, and you can easily go back and calculate back to a mixed number just to make sure you did the math correct. It's a very easy process. And we're going to be using this process when we're multiplying and dividing with fractions. And so the next video that I make will be on multiplying with mixed numbers.